Hello everyone, my name is David. I want to thank you all for coming. I do wish everyone to know that my daughter is certainly number one. Anything that I can do with the court requirements to continue the love, honor, and protection of my child, as well as Jessica, I will most certainly do.
I'm sorry.
No, please go ahead.
Your love for your daughter is evident, but everyone's got to ask. You guys had a marijuana grow house in your house, allegedly. How could you raise your daughter around in that kind of environment?
You know, that's a great question. I understand what you're saying. At this time, I've just received new counsel. The counsel's not here right now, and I prefer not to discuss any pending criminal charges moving forward. We'll certainly address that.
Data, can you talk about what happened at the hospital last weekend? There were concerns about you. They said you came to the hospital in an aggressive manner.
Once again, I am simply here to do anything the court requires of me to bring Penelope back home. Any of that, I certainly wish to address with my counsel first before I give any statements concerning that. But thank you for that.
Before all of daughter over the weekend.
I was seeing her today.
Before all of this, did you have any concerns about Penelope's size or her health?
We have had some neighbors actually have voiced some concerns. Jessica and I are very serious about raising her holistically, only organic foods and whatnot. So perhaps now, obviously, that we're here, I'm glad that she is receiving medical attention. And again, I will certainly do anything the court requires of me to move forward so we can bring Penelope back home.
David, do you realize the time that you wasted, the money that you wasted, and the scare that you gave everybody when you didn't tell people where your daughter was?
I understand, and I certainly know Jessica very, very well. We all hear a lot of stories, and I know Jessica was probably very, very scared. I certainly understand that.
Why did you not tell police where she was located?
Again, I will certainly do anything that I can to bring Penelope back home. Is there anything else? Thank you.
Good morning. I don't know if you have any questions. Some of you were there, so you know what happened. This is just a pretty straightforward hearing. It's a review hearing. Everything's going the way we want it to. Jessica and now David's going to be able to visit with baby Penelope. That's great. We're just trying to keep that going. We're still trying to figure out what the issues are medically, if there are any. Obviously, there's some failure to thrive concerns. And she's getting great care right now, so we should have answers pretty soon to that. And we're going to do whatever we need to. So it's pretty straightforward right now. Not too much exciting today.
Talk to us about the timeline. I know that there is an arraignment in June. There is a judicial review in October. Yeah. There was another June date. Is that June of 2016?
No.
Would it be a mediation? When is that?
Here's what's coming up. Mediation is coming up first, even before the arraignment. The judicial review is always put out about 6 months just to keep track of the case so that it doesn't get lost in the system. We'll have things resolved well before then, in my opinion. Mediation is going to be a good opportunity to try and get this case moved forward. Where we're going to go, work out a case plan. We should know more about the medical condition of Penelope by then. I think everyone's concern, including the department, is what's wrong with her, if anything, and how do we fix it? It could be environmental. It could be gastrointestinal. We're going to find out, and how to get her back on the chart where she should be for growth. And that's really the main focus.
Will she stay in state care until she's back at an acceptable, quote-unquote, level with the state?
The way that works, right now, the DCF has some control over her. It's called, basically, the dependency. That's going to be ongoing until the case plan is completed. But within that construct, they try and get the family back together as soon as possible. Right now, she's undergoing medical care, mainly to make sure she's properly hydrated and given good nutrition, and to find out what, if anything, is medically wrong with her. So once we get past that stage, then we'll know where she can best be treated. If that's back at a house with mom and dad, they'll do that. If it needs to be some intermediary place, we'll figure that out. My gut is once she is stable medically and identified as to what needs to happen to make her healthy, then they're going to reunite as soon as they can.
Was Jessica drug tested today? Were you drug tested today?
Yes.
Can you talk about that and why?
I'm not sure that I can give the results, but we have acknowledged that in the past Jessica has smoked pot. No question about that. And quite honestly, so have a lot of people who parent their children. However, in this case, now that we're in the crosshairs of DCF, we need to be even better than most. So She is drug-free, has been for the past week and a half, is going to continue to be. And the future drug test for things like pot, which you know is fat-soluble, stays in the blood, stays in the fat for a while, will be clean within 20 days or so. At that point, we can reestablish mother's milk, and it's going to help with ongoing contact. So it's pretty straightforward.
Mark, do you mind if we ask Jessica a question?
Not at all. I'm sorry.
Can you tell us what Penelope's weight was this weekend?
I think it was just under 12 pounds.
Had you seen a doctor prior to being taken into state custody?
I don't believe so.
Jessica, do you mind if we ask you, what are you willing to do to get your daughter back?
I would do everything that it takes to get her back with me. I just want her happy and healthy. I love her very much, and I would love to nurse her soon and just make her smile and bring her home.
Had she been nursing regularly? Had she been eating? Like, what was she taking in?
Her whole life I've been nursing her on demand. Just whenever she wants me to, I've been nursing her.
Did you have concerns that she was thin? Visibly she looks thin. Did you have concerns that she was thin?
Her eyes are so bright and beautiful, and her smile is just amazing. And she's a tiny baby, and I just thought she was lovely. She was never seemed sickly to me at any time.
Jessica, what's it been like over the last couple of days knowing that state and county authorities have your child, which it appears like you haven't really trusted them in the past, but now they have kind of control over your child? What is that like, that you have visitation rights, but you don't have control over your own child?
I've learned a lot of lessons in the last few weeks, and I'm just doing everything I can to be on the right track with Penelope so I can have her back with me soon.
Talk about those lessons. What did you learn?
What did I learn? Well, she's definitely underweight, and I probably should have taken her to a medical doctor before now. And I'm just glad she's getting the medical care that she needs right now to be healthy.
Jessica, could you explain why you don't trust
the deadline from last week when you were supposed to go to a doctor, and that kind of started the amping up of police and mm-hmm. the search for you and so forth? What happened? Why didn't you make that last appointment?
I was just very apprehensive on what they would say, and I was scared and I overreacted, but I'm back now and I'm ready to do whatever it takes to get Penelope back.
I want to make sure she answers the right question. Last Friday was our attempt to get her treated medically
right.
where she was.
Right.
Efforts were made to do that. I think we mentioned that the other day,
but
and Jessica can
deadline.
Talk about
what
that. What happened was they gave us until 4 o'clock to get that done Friday. Jessica went with Penelope to 4 separate. Maybe I should just let her answer it.
Please.
Yeah, I did. I went to a walk-in clinic affiliated with the hospital. I went to a health department, and I went to 2 other walk-in clinics, and nobody would give her a checkup at that time in that short notice because she had not been vaccinated from her religious exemption.
Jessica, why don't you trust doctors? Why don't you trust doctors or the government?
It's not that I don't trust. I never said that I don't trust doctors or the government.
Well, then what was your hesitation, I guess, in going?
I didn't see a medical necessary need for her to be there at the time until
now.
Of course, I do. Yes, sir. Absolutely.
Jessica, how has motherhood been for you? Has this been a challenging time? I mean, mm-hmm. she's a young baby. You're young, and mm-hmm. it doesn't sound like you've had much guidance in this department.
I was doing the best that I could with the resources I had.
We heard that you gave up a baby for adoption.
Mm-hmm.
When did that happen, and why did you decide to not give Penelope up for adoption?
That happened in 2013, and I don't really feel comfortable talking about that right now.
Did you see the multiple televised press conferences about the authorities looking for you, and if you were watching then, if they reached you, what was going through your head then?
I didn't know about it until I heard that the pickup order had been signed, and then...
So you had not caught wind of
right.
the manhunts that were taking place?
That is correct.
Statewide?
That is correct.
Okay.
And Mark or Jessica, can you tell us a little bit about where you were, this compound that you're staying at?
It wasn't a compound, it was a house.
Okay.
It was just a friend's house. She actually left town not knowing that, don't forget, when she left, there was no order not to, there was no manhunt, there was no concern. DCF came to the house, it was actually Child Protective Services, and that frightened a young mom. And quite honestly, we talked about this before, it would frighten many young moms. Other influences were there that suggested they could take your baby away. So she left to stay with family members until this got figured out. I think, as she said, if she had realized that if baby was in more need than she comprehended back then it would have been dealt with better and differently. And certainly in retrospect, it would have been. But when she left, she went to her friend's house out of state to get away from what she thought was a problem. Then when she got a hold of me, we realized it was a problem, we did everything. And if you really look at it, every step she did since then was appropriate. Pictures, medical attempts to do the four people who couldn't get her in, got her back here almost immediately. And we were in touch with Seminole County from day one to get that done. So I understand that beforehand, but from that day forward, she's done everything appropriate.
When you were with these friends, did anyone else, your friends, aside from attorneys and things, did anyone else say the baby looked thin?
When I was away?
Yes.
No, sir. No.
Nobody saw a problem with the baby's weight?
Nobody.
And Jessica, I know you have a pretty excellent family. Are they going to be willing to help raise Penelope? Where do you want to see Penelope through the process while you're working to complete this detailed case?
I'm not sure about my family. I have to look into it and ask them.
Over the weekend, when you were able to be with Penelope, was David also visiting with her at any point? Or?
No, he's not, but he'll be able to visit her today.
Jessica, it's not been a couple of days that since Penelope has not been in your custody. You've been allowed visitation, but as a mother, how's it been not having her close to you?
It's hard. I miss nursing her. I miss making her smile and holding her all night, and it's hard for me, but I'm doing the best I can.
Jessica, what are your hopes moving forward, especially for your baby?
Happy, healthy, and back with mom and dad. Yes.